As Bitcoin and blockchain grew increasingly popular, banks and large corporations began to take notice of the potential applications of this new technology. However, while cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin wanted to eliminate the need for banks by creating a public distributed ledger, banks wanted to harness the same blockchain technology without making their own institutions redundant. Instead, banks wanted to use blockchain technology to create permission blockchains, or private networks in which some central authority controls who is able to take part in consensus and validate transactions in the network. This interest eventually led to the rise of enterprise blockchains. Such permission blockchains were not open and not trustless, and lacked the economic incentives we studied in the past. But this is all okay, since the goal here wasn't to create another public blockchain network like Bitcoin. Instead, it was to separate the blockchain from Bitcoin. The general movement was that of curiosity and competition, to see how blockchain technology could apply to businesses and improve their competitive edge. The sentiment around this was mixed, though. Many saw this as just glorified public key cryptography, and at its core, just a new buzzword to boost hype and traffic and stock prices. At the same time, others encouraged the research into fundamental blockchain technologies, as they were more compliant and better suited for enterprise use than associated public blockchain systems. While many use cases exist for enterprise blockchains, most problems that enterprise blockchains aim to solve fall within three broad classifications: solving coordination failures, horizontally integrating systems, and creating self-sovereign decentralized networks. Although many enterprises now wish to take advantage of blockchain technology, true enterprise blockchain solutions are typically very situational. In their current state, blockchains do the equivalent of making every computer hundreds or thousands of times less efficient, since each node in the network must redundantly make the same computations as other nodes in the network. In order to come to consensus, these nodes must then communicate with other nodes all around the world, which further introduces latency issues. As a result, blockchains are far less scalable than traditional systems. Additionally, blockchains introduce security risks, as hacks are no longer restrained to compromising data, but can also allow perpetrators to steal money directly. All these factors combined mean that enterprise blockchain use cases must have specific scaling and use case requirements that would make a non-blockchain solution unfeasible. And as previously mentioned, industry has shown that enterprise blockchains are most optimally used to solve coordination failures, horizontally integrate systems, and create self-sovereign, distributed, and decentralized networks. Let's look back at the previous slide. Coordination failures between multiple parties seeking to work together often exist due to trust issues. Blockchain solves this issue by creating arbitrary incentive structures and being able to operate in the public domain without the coordination of a central entity, making it ideal for enterprise projects such as public infrastructure. Blockchain is also an integration technology. It combines data silos together into a single integrated system that captures greater economies of scale. By ensuring data immutability, integrity, auditability, and authenticity, blockchains enforce a common API and data standard, allowing multiple systems to be immediately interoperable. And lastly, blockchain provides new decentralized models to work with, alongside existing centralized ones, thus preventing the possibility of centralized corruption.